Last year, I introduced my two-way hero ISO build, a build with a 99 driving dunk that could also do just about everything else. But if you try making that build this year, well, it just doesn't work. So I spent hours upon hours cooking up and labbing in the builder to try to recreate the two-way hero build. And ladies and gentlemen, I found a masterpiece. And later in this video, we're gonna be showing how this build plays against competitive players featuring 7 different toxic stage lineups. So drop a like on the video, subscribe to the channel, because this ISO build will take over NBA 2K24. What is good, YouTube? It's your boy Henry, AKA DoubleH, back at it with yet another Yo. What is Brody doing? Yo, this is an amazing ISO build, but it's got people doing that. Anyways, this ISO build is going to take over NBA 2K24. And wow, I mean, he is literally bending. Oh, yo, I wanted to get straight into this video, but look at what this build has y'all doing. This dude is on the floor, bro. The same guy. The next play, I'm stepping over him. Okay, that was just a little disrespectful. We didn't have to do that to him. But this guy, oh, yo, again. Another dude bending. Yo, hey, yo. You see, we're on a little win streak in the stage. Run off the dribble, going to the rack. And oh, yo, yo, legs up in the air. Nah, that got it. That's got it. Level 40 Grizzlies mascot guarding me on this new ISO build. That's not going to be enough. Oh, my God. Yo, yo, yo. Okay, this one is crazy. All right, seriously, though, I need y'all to drop a like on the video if you guys want to build a tutorial on how to make this build, because this build is got to be the best attributes I've ever seen on a 2K24 build. Like, y'all know how you have to, like, sacrifice, you know, stats on a build to, you know, get what you want. Like, this build, there's really no holes in it except for one, and honestly, it's not even noticeable. Okay, this build goes absolutely crazy, and honestly, ever since I've made it, I have had 10 times more fun on 2K24, okay? I also have a 93 win percent for this build, so this build works for all game modes, rec, twos, threes, ones. It also works for casual and competitive settings. I've won wagers on this build, which will be coming soon. So if you guys want the wager videos, make sure to drop a like, because I plan on, you know, playing some very good players in 2K24. It also works for screens and ISO, so drop a like on the video for the build tutorial. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, because a lot of y'all aren't subscribed, because we got a lot of ISO coming to y'all in 2K24. I know I've been, you know, taking a lot of screens on my 6-6, but this build is just too much fun and too good to not play on, okay? You're seeing a lot of gameplay in the back right now, but what we're gonna do is show some competitive stage gameplay of what this build does against some comp stage players. And throughout the video, I'm gonna give some attributes that this build does have and some other things about the build that are just really insane. So anyways, let's get into the gameplay. Game number one, I am playing against 2 GOAT tiers, and every single game in this video is actually gonna be double GOAT tiers except for one game. And we're playing against a 7-footer and a 6'8" ISO lock build. And look at the first possession. I go for a dunk meter dunk and he blocks it. So this guy's got block on his build. He's got steal. He's got perimeter defense. He has a lot. Now with force against left, Swags forgets that the shot clock's going down and we go with the ball, right? So now we're on defense already. And this 6'8 ISO build, yes, y'all saw my build is 6'8, the ISO build I'm on, has good steal rating. It has an 85 steal. So you're going to get silver interceptor. You're going to get silver glove. And bro, what? My boy Swags is actually a really good shooter. Okay, he missed a couple shots, but we good. We good. He missed the first shot. I go for another dunk meter. And look at this guy's defense. I mean, he is a 6'8" lockdown defender. But once again, we have that 85 steal, bro. 85 steal is actually really good in 2K24. So we get a lot of stops with this build. This build has plenty of other good defensive stats as well. You see, I get to the midi. This build does have a pretty good mid-range, a higher mid-range than its three-pointer. Its three-pointer is good as well. You see, I'm wide open off the step back. Not sure why I didn't shoot that, but we Magic Johnson over, and we get the windmill dunk meter dunk. Now, I usually go with a dunk meter dunk on 95% of my drive attempts with this build, and that's because the dunk rating is so high. And that dunk that you just saw, the windmill, is actually Michael Jordan dunk package, because we have a very high driving dunk on this build, and we are also higher than a starter three. You see the strength layup, by the way. This build does have strength as well. Look at that, how this build is moving. Like, you guys gotta remember, this is 6'8" build, and oh my gosh, we are throwing this dude to the floor. I mean, we get crazy contact dunks in this build. I have sharp take, I have heat check, I'm doing hop jumpers over here. I mean, this build can literally do everything offensively. There's nothing this build at a 6'8" height cannot do on offense. I'm not even kidding. It has zero weaknesses in its offense. We dot swags on the left right there. By the way, this build also gets gold dimer. I'm just going to be throwing out a bunch of random attributes throughout the video with this build. Yes, we get gold dimer on this build. The passing is very good. Look at, I'm dotting my boy Swags right now, who is on a 6'8 center build. And yeah, I'm just as tall as a lot of centers are in this stage. We are playing against a 7-foot center right here. But y'all got to remember, when I'm dribbling and I'm like moving around on offense, y'all got to remember, I'm 6'8 and we finished that game right there with the green dunk. I am 6'8, y'all, just like my two-way hero build from last year. And peep the 23 game win streak in this stage. But yeah, 6'8 moving like this, doing what we're doing. It's pretty crazy. Going into game number two, though, we are playing the only goat tier of the video, or non-goat tier of the video, but he's a 6'2 sweaty point guard build. And this is what happens when one of these short guard builds tries to guard my 6'8 iso build. It's just it's simply not gonna work. As soon as I get the ball, I run for the MJ dunk and we get that to go. Okay, now this is what I like to call an L cut, a V cut, whatever, on the twos. And it's basically just to avoid them wanting to switch, because I know they want to switch, right? And look at how much this guy's leaving me wide open, but I still can just get a standing dunk. This build does have standing dunk, so you get driving content dunks, you get standing dunks. He's leaving me wide open. I miss. Now, I don't miss often. If you guys see some of the intros of this video, I'm shooting like 65% from three on this build, which is pretty crazy. Even with all these shooting updates, I hate the last shooting update. Look at another crazy standing dunk animation right there. The reverse dunks this build gets, by the way, are insane. I can finesse my way under the basket when the shot clock's going down. We hit the three right there. Yeah, like I said, this build can shoot everywhere on the court. I can get contact dunks. I'm dribbling like crazy on 6'8. Look at me fading in the corner. Look at a layup. There's nothing this 6'2 guy can do. He can't get a contest on me. And if I want to, I don't even have to shoot the ball. I can just force a dunk every play. So these small guards, even though they're way faster than me on defense, it's not gonna matter, okay? We're on the fireball, easy dunk. I mean, look how that easy that was for me to create space. Now that he has to respect my shot, the dunk is just wide open. Look at how deep I am with sharp takeover. Oh my gosh. By the way, this build does not have limitless range. It doesn't even have bronze limitless range. So yeah, sharp take is just crazy in 2K24. Now I can hit shots like that. I did miss that. It was a wide open though. But I can hit shots on that, like that, on this build, okay? So we give up a three right there. We finally give up the ball by just me making a mistake. Okay, that's the only time you're really gonna give up the ball on this build, is if it pulls you out of a dunk or you just miss open once you get, you know, used to obviously using the build. But you see, we get the good rotation from Swags right there. He's gonna pull it out right quick with sharp takeover. Gonna go ahead and shoot some dunk stuff and give it right back to them. But hey, we gotta go back on defense right now. Like I said, this build has good defense. We have maximum wingspan on this iso build, which is very key. Like in other 2Ks, maximum wingspan is like a normality kind of thing. Like it's just normal for most builds. But in this 2K, a lot of people don't have max wingspan, especially 6'6s. There's like no 6'6s that go max wingspan. But this 6'8, max wingspan, y'all. Look at this dude's moving pretty good. I'm playing good defense. I'm here. We clamping that. I'm on that. And he catches the ball with no energy. He misses, hits me back. I'm not missing open, especially off the catch and shoot. You know, sometimes I miss open, but off the catch and shoot. No, 26 game win streak in the stage. By the way, that streak ended up going to 30. Game number three, we were playing a post lock lineup. Yeah, it's a 6'6 post score, or no, 6'7 post score and a 6'7 lock. It was a weird lineup. I don't know. Y'all are going to see how they play when they get the ball. And I'm just showing a bunch of different stage games. To be honest, ever since season two came out, all I've been playing is stage. I'm going to start posting some wagers too, because right now I'm really just having a lot of fun playing like competitive 2K. Like I'm not really having fun like just playing anybody. I want to play some good players, right? Let me know if y'all want me to like the 1 million VC challenge to come back or something like that. Maybe I can stream that, or, you know, maybe I can just stream stage. Let me know if y'all want streams to return with this build. Anyways, look at this. Oh my gosh, the contact dunk. This build is so fun. I can't explain to y'all how fun this build is. And I know I'm in the stage, so this is like a competitive setting, but this build is 10 times even more fun in the park. Like, y'all think this build is unstoppable against comp? Bro, people in the park can't touch this build. Like, they cannot do anything against this build. Look at this dude's fouling me right here. We're up 7-0. I haven't even needed to shoot a three right here. Another easy dunk. Green that dunk right there. We're up 9-0 right now. I hit Swags. He shoots the midi fade, gets it to go. Once again, I do have gold dimer. Now, Swags doesn't even need dimer, to be honest, because he's a good shooter, but it's just another perk with the build, okay? Now, look at this. This dude's pressing me like crazy. And when you press crazy on me, I'm always gonna drive by. If this build ever has a defender on its hip, it's an automatic green dunk. You have to be square in front of me to stop my dunk. Otherwise, I'm dunking the ball. The dunk rating is way too high on this build to be on the side of it to stop it. It's not gonna work, especially when I'm using the dunk meter. Now we're in takeover, 15-0. We zooming right by him. Once again, he's just playing so high. Like in this game right here, I don't even need to end up shooting the ball, okay? If people don't disrespect your three, then you're just gonna get a dunk every play, basically. Right here, they finally get a stop. They ended up poking the ball loose and getting it. And by the way, this team started with ball. And look at, he's a post score. Like, look how this dude's playing. Spins off me, swags helps. That's an easy three for them. So now it's time to get a stop, okay? Now my build does have strength. Not as a high strength as the guy I'm guarding, which you're gonna see, that's why he throws me out the way right there. But my build does have strength. There are other versions of this build that don't have strength. And when I've dropped the build video, when y'all, you know, drop a like on this video and get the likes up, I'm gonna show you a bunch of different versions of this build that you can make. Yeah, this build does have strength on it. As you can see, we're still gonna get stops though. 85 steal. All you need in this game is a steal, to be honest. I mean, you're gonna need perimeter defense and stuff like that, but if you have a steal, you're gonna get your stops. Okay, so look at, I didn't even attempt a three that game, and we won with ease. 10 for 10, one turnover against a post log lineup. Game number four, we are playing against a 6'8" GOAT tier center and a 6'6" meta build at point guard GOAT tier as well. Now the 6'6", as you see, gets a steal off rip. Now my build is 6'8", so it can't get gold unpluckable unless you upgrade the post control, and I did not upgrade the post control. So I do have silver unpluckable, but if I'm gonna be honest with y'all, I don't notice the difference between silver and gold. It's like the same thing. But anyways, this is the 6'6" build we're going against. This is the probably the most common height build in 2K24 is 6'6". Okay, so you guys are gonna see what happens when we go against it. Obviously, we start with a turnover right here. Hop step. I have bail out on this build, by the way. So we bail it out to swags, open, didn't shoot it. Hit him back, shoots that, and he misses. So, you know, this is one of those games, you know, you're gonna have games like this where it just starts off slow. I haven't really made a mistake. Like, my teammate missed open and I got ripped. I haven't really made a mistake, but it's a slow start. And that happens in 2K. That's gonna happen. As you can see, though, I'm clamping this dude. Like, I might be a little slower because I'm 6'8", but you can play great defense with a max wingspan, the taller frame with this build. They get the slip dunk right there, though, so that's fine. We are down 4-0 to start this game. Look, I'm playing him super high because I can play people super high. You get silver and movable four-star on this build, so it's probably best to play people high on this build with how long your wingspan is, how tall you are, and that you have strength. So that's what I do to most guards that play like this guy plays right here. He gets out to the easy mid. He misses that with no energy because we were playing good defense on him throughout the possession. 4-0. They're trying to get it back to him. They're playing it nice and slow. Like, you can tell this team is very locked in. Like, they want to win this game back. 3 seconds on the shot clock. He has no energy because I've been clamping him up the whole play. 2 seconds. We get this steal. We finally get the ball back. Now, we have 3 seconds left. I dot swags wide open, and he misses again. Okay, I promise Slags is a goated shooter, so it just happens. We miss. It's 2K24. Everybody be missing in this game once in a while open. But look at me hawking the lanes. Once again, 85 steals, so we get silver interceptor. Sometimes I get the animation, sometimes I don't. But if you're in the lanes, timing it right, you're going to get your steals in the lanes. And right there, we get the step back three. Once again, I'm shooting 65% from three on this build.
I mean, I'd really just be throwing steamers, bro.
And you see, I'm on my live comment, I'm talking about I'm throwing steamers. This is because this build gets an 89 pass iron. And look at that dunk. The dunk rating is insane on this build. But yes, we get an 89 pass sack. This is a 6'8" point guard build with an 89 pass sack. And y'all know all my point guard builds usually have like a 75 or 63 pass sack, because I really believe in that. But this build had so much extra stats left over that I can get Tyrese Halliburton passed out. So why not? I feel like if you take screens, you don't need as high as a pass sack. But bro, on ISO, when you have a high pass sack like this build does, oh, it gets crazy. No one's double teaming me. Look at me back in the lanes with silver interceptor. But I can't wait till I show y'all this build. Make sure to drop a like, because look at, I can shoot, throw dots like that. The center barely helped. He barely was off my teammate. But guess what? My pass sack is so high that if you even think about helping, or forget that you're just ball watching, whatever, I can instantly pass it to my teammate, and he's gonna be open if he shoots it. Right here, I get the little moving crossover open in the dunk because he's guarding me super high, because yes, I have takeover and I can shoot from out there. 18-4 game point if I shoot a three. But look at, we just get the little strength layup once again. This build does have strength. We have an 84 strength on this build, so we get a lot of the silver strength badges defensively and offensively. Right here, little spin jumper, and honestly, I usually make those, okay? That's a very makeable shot on this build, but we do miss right there. But yeah, those shots are very good shots. Like, once again, the mid-range is higher than the three-pointer on this build. Look at, I'm in the lane, I'm reaching right there, I'm playing great defense. I mean, y'all can tell in this gameplay, like, I'm making my opponent look bad. Like, I really am. Y'all probably like, oh, this dude's trash. Like, these are GOAT tiers in the stage. Like, these dudes can hoop. We're just making them look trash because our defense is crazy. Swags with a hop back jumper, green, get him off the court. That's another W in the books. And that game was early on in the streak. But going on to game number five, we are playing a very good ISO dribbler who is a 6'4 GOAT tier and a 6'9 GOAT tier center. So once again, it's just GOAT tiers after GOAT tiers, competitive games after competitive games. We're in the stage, cross plays on, I'm up here and online. We're ready for all the action, you know what I'm saying? And I really haven't even, and guys, just so y'all know, I haven't really ISO'd in 2K24. You know what I mean? Like, I've been taking screens on my 6'6 this whole, like, for the first month and a half of the game. So, like, this is my first build where, like, I'm really ISOing out here. And I've been enjoying it a lot. This build makes the game 10 times more fun. But right here, you see, I miss an open midi on catch and shoot to start the game. I'm not going to lie, that's extremely rare of me. That's a layup for me, usually. Anyways, we're on defense. You see, this guy's moving a little shifty with it. I'm playing good defense. His corner misses open right there. We secure the rebound. We have the ball. I dot Swags. Easy open three. He misses, though. Like, our centers are just missing open threes right now. But anyways, back on defense. We're guarding the ISO, and he gets a great stop-and-pop shot right there. Great shot by him, giving them the 3-0 lead to start. And look it, I'm back on defense. You know, like I said, this build has, I'm confident when I'm on defense with this build. That's all I'm going to say. 7'6" wingspan right there. Though he gets another layup. Back on defense once again, it's 5-0. And then honestly, this guy was pretty good. I just feel like his shot selection sometimes was a little off and he over dribbled a little bit, which is how most dribblers are. Once again, we have bailout on this build, so we can bail out of stuff like that. But bro, I don't know what was going on with Swags in some of these gameplays, but he was not hitting in some of these games. But I think this was like right after the shooting update, and I was struggling a little bit too. But that's just 2K24. Like I said, bro, like, if y'all are struggling with shooting, I have a how to shoot video on my channel, and I also have jump shot videos on the channel as well if you guys are interested in that. But look at the little easy midway, or I said midway, mid-range shot. I actually like the offhand shot right there better than to my left side, even though I'm left-handed with this build. I don't know, kind of weird. Let me know if y'all are the same with your builds. Another easy mid-range fade, and y'all are gonna see in this gameplay right here how crazy effective my mid-range is on this build. Like, look at this. I can really just fade. If I really want to, I can just run right, left, fade a midi, get takeover, and it's over. You know what I mean? Right here, that's a greenable shot. I know it was a 28%, but this build can green shots like that. I have green shots like that. And once again, they're spamming. They're trying to get the steal. I get the easy fadeaway mid-range again. Once again, the mid-range is good on this build. I have an 84 mid-range on this build, so we get gold mini magician. And back to the dunk meter we go. My favorite part about this build, which makes playing 2K24 way better. Like, all my other builds don't really have dunk in this game. This build, with a high dunk rating, it's so fun, bro. I'm telling you, like, I don't usually try to convince people of making builds out here. But I usually just show my builds and y'all can make your assumptions or opinions. But I really enjoy playing with this build. Anyways, 8-for-12, not a bad game right there. Going into game number six, we are playing another clan, double GOAT tiers, a 6'8", and I think it was another 6'8", maybe a 6'9". Anyways, lockdown guarding me right here, and we go down early in this game. As you see, I get a dunk meter dunk to start the game. Once again, if anyone's on my hip, the green window's gonna be crazy on my dunk meter. You have to be in front of me for that dunk to not work. So yeah, dunking on this build. Once again, if it wasn't already clear, it's very overpowered. But skipping to 17-2, we finally get a stop. So can we make comebacks in the stage with this build? I grant a dunk, I get blocked. So nothing's really going our way. We don't really have any momentum. I'm in negative takeover, catch and shoot three, and I'm still in negative takeover. I still have nothing to my takeover after hitting a three-pointer right there. 5-0, magic over to the left. I dot Swags. He played good defense on that. I probably should have took the dunk. And we're going back to the ISO once again. Magic Johnson over to the left. Kevin Durant over to the right. And look at that little layout right there. Like, Those little random strength animations is why I am glad that I upgraded my strength on this build. It is truly an advantage. 17-9, we're back at it. He's clearly spamming, trying to get that steal. I don't blame him. It's overpowering 2K24, and we catch the other defender sleeping. That's a quick dot. You know, sometimes I really got to pass more on this build, because with the 89 pass stack, you can really catch the defender slipping, bro. You can also stun the defenders with how fast your pass style is with the Tyrese Haliburton. Anyways, back to the basics, going to the dunk, and oh my gosh, bro, it's crazy. Like, I'm not scoring on a build with not a high dunk on that possession right there. I hope y'all know that. 17-16, right back to the magic. Once again, I'm not scoring that either without a high dunk in the dunk meter. Like, this build gets so many extra tough buckets even when the defense is playing good defense. 18-17, we're basically at game point. I have one adrenaline bar and I get ripped. No. Drive into the basket, kicks it out to his teammate, back out to his teammate with takeover, and gets another layup, and it's game point. 19-18. Is this going to be our first loss of the video? Is this going to be our... And by the way, I have a 93 win percent in stage this season. 500 games played. Y'all know record resets. I've only been playing stage this season. So there's my record on the screen. Anyways, back to the gameplay. Wide open for three. Can he make it? He missed. Yo, he's not built for the game. He could not hit the game winner. It got to his head. It was too much pressure. 19-18. Back to the basics. Easy dunk. He's guarding me from way out there. I'm going to take my dunk. Once again, playing me high. I probably could have shot that right there, but guess what? We have a 94 driving dunk, y'all. We can take dunks like that. Yes, this build gets a 94 driving dunk, 82 vertical. It's crazy. It's crazy what this build is capable of. Once again, going into game number 7, I'm having an extreme amount of fun on this build. Let me know what y'all want to see with this build. Wagers, streams, challenges. I know last year we did, and by the way, we're playing a clan right here. He's on a 6-5 and he's ISOing, and these guys play a lot of stage. This clan right here, they be playing a lot of stage, so they be sweating. We get the little moving crossover into the standing bug. But yeah, last year I did, 2K22, I did the million VC challenge, 0 to 1 million. Last year I did 60-99. Let me know, is there another big challenge? I know only my loyals are watching right now. Is there another big challenge video I could do that y'all have an idea on? If not, maybe I could do one of those again. But yeah, let me know in the comments, okay? Because we about to be grinding out the videos and the streams and the shorts and all that. Anyways, we get the ball back. They start fouling. I hit the back door because I just can't on this build. I have a high pass accuracy. I can make passes that I can't on some other builds that I have. Anyways, we're up 4-0. This dude gets the lane and they're locked in. Good defense. We got to get a stop. Okay, that's just how the stage is. You can't be throwing bad passes like that. And Swags has like a 70 pass accuracy, so his pass was a little slow right there. You know, maybe with my 89 pass accuracy, we could have got that pass through, but not right there. Anyways, on defense, we're playing great defense. 6 seconds on the shot clock, 5 seconds on the shot clock, and he just has too low energy to hit that after dribbling around the whole play. So we get the ball back, AI step back, and that's green. I love shooting off that. And honestly, I wasn't using that this move right here, this AI step back move, the John Wall step back, as much as I should have been when I first made this build. But look at this play. I get one jump in. He's hand in the face. Wow. That play shows you how crazy this build is. Like, you can really shoot stuff like that and make it. You can shoot stuff like that and make it too. I mean, this game right here, if this singular game, this game 7 of the video, doesn't show you how crazy this build is, then I don't know, bro. We haven't missed a shot this game, bro. We genuinely haven't missed a shot. We're getting contact dunks. Oh, my. Hall of Fame spin cycle on this build, y'all. Can we get our instant replay? I mean, where is he going? Bro, really trying to act out like he was trying to switch that. No, he got messed up. Another easy dunk meter dunk. Drop a like on the video right now if you want the build video. Subscribe to the channel to watch some wagers that we're going to be doing this build. It's been your boy Henry, aka DoubleH, and I'm out, y'all. I'll talk to y'all in the comments. Peace.